Let us move to the next article, 7.7, which is the calorimetry. See, calorimetry is an experimental technique for the quantitative measurement of heat exchange. To make such measurement, a calorimeter which is used. Let us see in this figure. Figure shows a simple water calorimeter. It consists of a cylindrical vessel made of copper or aluminium and provided with a stirrer and a lid. The calorimeter is well insulated to prohibit any transfer of heat into or out of the calorimeter. One important use of calorimeter is to determine the specific heat of a substance using the principle of conservation of energy. Here we are dealing with the heat energy and the system which is isolated from the surrounding. Therefore, heat gain is equal to the heat lost. In this technique, known as the method of mixtures, means a sample A of the substance is heated to a high temperature, which is accurately measured. The sample A is then placed quickly in the calorimeter containing the water. Then the contents are stirred constantly until the mixture attains a final common temperature. The heat loss by the sample A will be gained by the water and the calorimeter. The specific heat of the sample A of the substance can be calculated as, let us consider, M1 is the mass of the sample A, M2 is the mass of the calorimeter and the stirrer, then M3 is the mass of the water in the container, then S1, which is the specific heat capacity of the substance of sample A, S2, which is the specific heat capacity of the material of the calorimeter, which includes the stirrer, S3, which is the specific heat capacity of water, then T1, which is the initial temperature of the sample A, T2 is the initial temperature of the calorimeter, stirrer and water, then capital T, which is nothing but the final temperature of the combined system. We have then calculate, or we have the data, which is nothing but the heat loss by the sample A, which is nothing but M1 S1 into T1 minus T2. Then heat gain by the calorimeter and the stirrer, which is given by M2 S2 into T minus T2. Okay, heat gain by the water also, which is M3 S3 into T minus T2. Assuming no loss of heat to the surroundings, the heat loss by the sample goes into the calorimeter, stirrer and water. Thus, writing heat equation as M1 S1 into T1 minus T is equal to M2 S2 into T minus T2 plus M3 S3 into T minus T2. Knowing the specific heat capacity of water, S3 is equal to 4186 joule per kg per Kelvin, and the copper, means S2, is equal to 387 joule per kg per Kelvin. Being the material of the calorimeter and the stirrer, one can calculate the specific heat capacity S1 of material of sample A, which is as equation S1 is equal to M2 S2 plus M3 S3 into T minus T2 upon M1 into T1 minus T. Also, one can find the specific heat capacity of water or any liquid using the expression, if the specific heat capacity of the material of calorimeter and the sample, which is known by that equation, S3 is equal to M1 S1 into T1 minus T upon M3 into T minus T2 minus M2 S2 upon M3. In this experiment, the heat from the solid sample A, which is given to the liquid, and therefore the sample should be denser than the liquid, so that the sample does not float on the liquid.